budget, besides throwing out some financial numbers, also lays down the policy direction in different sectors in the country. So what we, one of the expectations that we have from current year's budget is to give the direction to the education sector in the country, which in a way is also illustrated in the draft National Education Policy, where we are trying to make a shift from literacy to learning and from access to quality. And when I say that, it covers the entire spectrum of education, from early childhood education all the way up to the higher education. So there are quite a few things which need to be done, and we hope the budget paves the way for the country to embark on that. When we talk about the education sector, FICCI thinks that there are three challenges which are actually glaring at us right now. First and foremost is how we actually embark on the journey of implementing the National Education Policy in true letter and spirit to achieve the goal of, you know, educating and empowering each and every citizen of India. The second glaring challenge that we are facing with is the whole industry 4.0 and the future of jobs, which are at threat because of automation. So what kind of learning should be provided, or how we skill and how we train and prepare our youth to be good contributors to the nation building. And the third challenge that we have to face is, if we have to achieve the SDG 4 by 2030, the total investment required in these 17 years is about $2.3 trillion, which translates to something like $173 billion a year. The current government spend on education is less than one third of that on an annual basis. So from where would this investment come from? Obviously, I think the clear answer is that the government alone or state alone can't fund that kind of an investment. It has to come from private sources. We have to tap each and every source of capital, and we have to draw capital using each and every asset that we have to make this happen. So we hope that the budget paves way for certain specific directions or certain specific initiatives which will facilitate this kind of an investment to happen. And FICCI has drawn a few of such initiatives which the finance minister can embark on. The first such initiative is to allow all different kind of formats to be able to set up and run educational institutions. A corporate entity has access to capital markets both nationally and internationally, and when a corporate entity can set up every other social sector initiative or establishment, why can't it set up a school or a college or a university? The second very specific suggestion that we have is, this government had brought out the path-breaking initiative in its last regime of introducing REITs and InvITs as a source of raising capital for long gestation projects, specifically the ones that are capital intensive. Education is clearly one sector. So if the budget can pave a way for allowing the existing educational institutions to corporatize and break themselves into a PropCo and OpCo, so that they can use their existing assets, leverage them to raise capital, which can be used for enhancement and expansion of the sector. So these two are the very specific initiatives that we expect the finance minister to come out with in the forthcoming budget. So FICCI's message, recommendation, request, prayer to the FMAs, that FICCI has always believed in standing with the government, not just demanding from the government. So when it comes to the challenge of investments, we say that we also are standing with the government to raise that investment. When it comes to empowering the citizens of India, we always promote that yes, the empowerment should be made, and in education sector it could be made by way of switching to the direct benefit transfer scheme, where we empower our parents with the freedom of choice and the freedom of decision making, and make institutions accountable for each and every penny of the money that the government rolls out to the parents, because the institutions will have to perform to be able to attract that kind of money. So our message to the finance minister is that we always consider ourselves as part of the government, and we stand with the honorable finance minister in realizing our vision and our dream of making India once again a knowledge destination for the world, where we promote education tourism so that we start attracting students both for school and higher education from different countries to come and study in India.